Everyone may have had some form of hip pain in life. The stiffness and discomfort on the hip joint when moving the body, that's even experienced by a tough guy like Arnold Schwarzenegger. But replacing your entire hip because of it is something else. Is a total hip replacement surgery necessary for your hip pain? To know the answer, let's have a close look at the hip anatomy. Our hip is a ball and socket joint that consists of two parts. The femoral head, which is a ball-shaped structure at the top end of the femur, or the thigh bone, and the acetabulum socket in the pelvis that fits perfectly to the femoral head. Both surfaces are covered with a smooth and slippery connective tissue called the articular cartilage. The joint structure is confined by synovial membrane, whose fluid lubricates the cartilage. Together, the articular cartilage and the synovial fluid helps reduce almost all friction, thus allowing smooth movement. However, this ideal condition may not last long. Osteoarthritis, or wear and tear type of arthritis, may cause elderly or people with a family history of arthritis to experience hip erosion. In this erosion situation, the uneven cartilage surface cushioning the bones of the hip increases the friction of the bones and causes hip pain and stiffness. Hip pain caused by arthritis in the early stage is preferably relieved by non-surgical treatment, such as drugs and nutraceuticals, physical therapy, injections, assistive devices, and lifestyle change. But if the pain is intensifying, reducing mobility, and interrupting everyday tasks, then it is time to consult your doctor for the surgical option. Beside osteoarthritis, other conditions that cause hip pain are rheumatoid arthritis. This is an autoimmune disease in which inflammation happens as the immune system attacks healthy cells, mistaken as foreign substances. It is characterized by swollen synovial membrane and cartilage erosion, leading to the damage of the hip joint. Post-traumatic arthritis. This is a type of arthritis as a result of a serious hip injury or fracture. Osteonecrosis, or also known as a vascular necrosis, is the death of the femoral head due to the lack of blood flow. The blood flow disruption can happen because of hip fractures, hip dislocations, or certain medical conditions and treatment. Childhood hip disease. Some children and teens may encounter particular hip problems, such as leg calviperthi syndrome and idiopathic juvenile arthritis, that may affect their later life, and therefore may need hip replacement. After being physically and mentally prepared for surgery, the patients have to be sure that they're willing and allowed to leave work or school for at least 6 weeks, and most importantly, have a good physiotherapist. There is no age or weight limit for this procedure, even though the average age of patients who undergo incisions are aged around 60 to 80, with very infrequent surgery on teens and young adults. Surgical routes are decided based on the severity of joint damage and the condition of the patient. For patients with mild damage on the femoral head, especially younger ones with higher activity like athletes, doctors tend to suggest the hip resurfacing procedure. This procedure trims the damaged femoral head and then resurfaces it with metal covering. When the injury or disease affects the femoral head way more than just mild damage, then surgeons perform a partial hip replacement, where they replace the damaged femoral head with a prosthetic whose stem is embedded into the femur. But when both the femoral head and the acetabulum are severely affected and cannot function properly, surgeons need to perform a total hip replacement, where the acetabulum is also replaced with a metal socket. Before performing hip replacement, the orthopedic surgeon requires the medical history, physical examination, x-ray, and sometimes MRI or CT scan of the patients to determine the extent of the joint damage. The current medication should be informed if there is any, and some of them must be stopped a week before the replacement, such as aspirin, anti-inflammatories, blood thinners, and supplements. Patients also need their dental problems solved before surgery to prevent germ infection on the joint. Quitting smoking and limiting alcohol intake is helpful to reduce any postoperative complications. Additionally, it is recommended to take exercises for hip muscle strengthening before surgery. For a better recovery period and experience, prepare a recovery room at home while keeping things in reach. Now, we are ready for the details in the operating room, which become our main discussion in the upcoming video, so stay tuned. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.